Good morning, children. I hope you have completed all the assignments of the first lesson, Sources. Now, we are going to start Geography, the Earth, our living planet. This is the first session of the Earth, our living planet. In this lesson, the Earth, our living planet, we are going to discuss few points. That is, do you know where we are living? Other names of the Earth, the size of the Earth and distribution of water on it, continents and oceans of the world. So let's start, children. We are living on the Earth. It is the third planet from the Sun. The Earth is the home for all forms of life like plants, animals, and human beings. Because of its suitable distance from the Sun, range of temperature, life supporting gases, atmosphere, water cycle, etc. Our Earth is called by many names like living planet, unique planet, watery planet, and blue planet. Earth is the only planet which supports life of plants, animals, and other creatures. It supports the life, so Earth is called as unique planet. Earth is consists 71% of water, so it is called as watery planet. Earth is also called as blue planet because from the space, because of the presence of water, Earth looks blue. So Earth is known as blue planet. These are the names of Earth. The names of Earth are living planet, unique planet, watery planet, and blue planet. The Earth is the fifth largest planet in the Sun's family. The diameter of the Earth is approximately 4 times greater than the Moon, and it is around 107 times less than that of the Sun. The total geographical area of the Earth is 510 million square kilometers, of which 361 million square kilometer means 70.78% is covered by water, and 149 million square kilometer is covered by land. Thus, the Earth has unequal distribution of land and water. The ratio between the land and the water bodies is 1:2.43. When we say about the shape of Earth, the Earth shape is often described as geoid, which literally means Earth shaped or oblate spheroid. The Earth is flattened at the poles and bulges at the equator. So if you observe an orange, children, not exactly like an orange, but the Earth resembles like an orange, slightly flattened at the bottom and slightly bulged on the top. So Earth looks like an orange. So you can observe this and you will come to know what is geoid shape. The equatorial diameter of the Earth is 12,756 kilometer, and the polar diameter is 12,714 kilometer. The difference of 42 kilometers in diameter is the proof for regarding the geoid shape of the Earth. Water covers the Earth 71%. The most that is in oceans. About a fifth of Earth atmosphere consists of oxygen produced by plants. Some amount of water is in the form of glaciers, ice caps, and in frozen condition. The shape of Earth is nearly spherical. There is a small flattening at the poles and bulging around the equator due to the oblate spheroid, whose equatorial diameter is 43 km, larger than the pole-to-pole diameter, although the variation is less than 1% of the average radius of the Earth. The land bodies on the Earth are known as continents. So, what are continents, children? A continent is one of the Earth's seven main divisions of land, and continents are a huge mass of land. The important continents are, if we arrange from largest to smallest, the order will be like this: Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Antarctica, Europe, and Australia. The continents are land masses of large size. Asia is the largest continent in the world, while Australia is the smallest continent. The land and water bodies are unevenly distributed between the northern and the southern hemisphere. The northern hemisphere has 60% of land and 40% of water. Therefore, it is called the land hemisphere. The large water bodies on the Earth are called oceans. There are four major oceans. They are Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, and the Arctic Ocean. The Pacific is the largest and deepest ocean in the world, and Arctic is the smallest and shallowest ocean. On the other hand, there is 81% of water and 19% of land in the southern hemisphere, and so it is called the water hemisphere. Children, these are the some important facts related to the Earth. So we came to know that Earth is a unique planet because it supports life. Earth is the only planet which is having atmosphere and water, which are necessary for the life. And even Earth is known as blue planet because it looks blue from the space. And Earth is also known as watery planet because 71% of the Earth consists water bodies. So these are the important things about the Earth. In the second session, we are going to learn about latitudes, longitudes, important latitudes and longitudes, and even the standard time and even the time distribution around the world. We'll meet in the second session, children. Till that, have a nice day. Thank you.